So, if you've seen my non-spoiler review of Suicide Squad, you know that I have major problems with this movie. However, I also said that it has glimpses of greatness, and here are the top five glimpses of greatness. Yes, the top five moments in Suicide Squad. And when you see the film, be sure to share your top five moments down below. And beware, there are spoilers ahead. Number four actually is the biggest spoiler of the list. So I have chapter times in the video description so you can skip around if you wanna avoid that one in particular. All right, but I'm gonna work my way backwards to the best moment in the movie. All right, so number five is any moment that Viola Davis's Amanda Waller is on screen. I loved her. She had the best lines and the best reactions. Like, her facial expressions were spectacular. Her badassness was everything I hoped it would be. Viola Davis took her Amanda Waller character, and I have to give her credit because her co-stars didn't come off nearly as well as she does here. So that leads me to believe that she had to do a lot of the heavy lifting herself, and she was competing with an Oscar winner, no less. But she not only made me believe that this character existed beyond the scenes in the film, but she did the best job honoring the comic book character that she's portraying. She not only was Amanda Waller from the comics, or is Amanda Waller from the comics, but she makes Amanda Waller cooler than the comics. She makes me want Amanda Waller to have her own comic, to be featured in more DC comics. It was just everything that you want the film adaptation of a comic book character to be. All right, so that was the fifth best moment in the movie. Now, number four, again, this is the big spoiler, so I'm going to give you a moment to go into the video description and skip to number three. All right, so number four, the fourth best moment in the movie was when Diablo goes full god. I didn't see that coming because he has never done it in the comics, but this was like the one good thing that David Ayer added to like the DC mythology that I was like, I like it. Like, they had dropped a little bit of hints, you know, like, oh, you don't know his powers, and he says, oh, you know, I've felt this way since I was a child, and my powers grew, but I had no idea what he was working with. And thank goodness, because for a lot of the movie, I was like, you know, everyone's making such a big deal about him, but he just is basically a giant flamethrower, a human flamethrower, right? But he delivered in the end, when he went like full apocalypto and like morphed into this fire god, right? And so I thought it was kind of cool. And Enchantress was like, hello, fellow god, basically. And I was like, what you talking about, Enchantress? And then he delivered. So I thought that was really, really cool. And also, this was the only time in the movie that Task Force X delivered on Amanda Waller's promise that they would fight metahumans with metahumans, right? For most of the movie, they didn't seem to have a particularly impressive set of skills, anyone. You know, you were like, I know some of you have said, well, that's what the Suicide Squad is. They're just expendable. Amanda Waller, if I worked for, you know, the Pentagon or whoever she was pitching this to, I'd be like, Waller, you promised me some razzle dazzle. And I just see, you know, soldiers who are not dressed following the dress codes. That was basically how it seemed. So for Diablo, though, that was pretty nice. And especially also caught me by surprise because, again, he's never done it in the comics. All right, so the third best moment in the movie was Harley Quinn's high wire act. I thought that whole sequence when she decided to jump for that that rope from the helicopter or helo that the Joker and his men had commandeered, I thought that whole thing was great. From her, you know, risking her life, of course, it's classic Joker-Harley dynamic. You risk your life, Harley, to come with me. So I thought that was good. And then also when she was on the rope, you know, it was one of the few moments in the movie where I think Harley Quinn was perfectly captured by not only Margot Robbie, but the movie itself. She incorporated her acrobatic abilities and then also her very childlike, playful behavior. So I liked when she was first flipping around on the rope, and being like, bye, everyone. And then when Deadshot was supposed to shoot her, I liked the way she fell on the rope. I was like, that was pretty cool. And then I liked the fake out and the gotcha wave. I thought that was just classic Harley. So I thought that was a really nice moment. I was like, that's where, you know, things gelled a little bit. So thank goodness. Then number two, the runner-up best moment of the movie was when the Joker enlisted Ike Barinholtz's Griggs to work for him. And also, Ike Barinholtz did Jared Leto a huge favor by getting that scene started off right by his reaction to when the Joker came in and just touched his shoulders. You know, just the fear that ran through Griggs, because this guy was just so unpredictable. The Joker did a lot to help Jared Leto's Joker, you know, make the audience feel the same way. So I loved that aspect of it. I loved when Jared Leto was like circling him like a shark, you know, like anything could happen. You know, it was a great electricity between them, which I guess Jared Leto could feel, because I loved when he put his hand out. You know, I felt a lot of the times Jared Leto was just kind of like, you know, stabs in the dark of like, maybe this will work. I don't know. And I mean, clearly Jared Leto was not an improviser. So when he put his hand out and Ike Barinholtz had to kiss it, and then the Joker like immediately sat on his lap and was like, I think you really meant that. Oh, it was so great. It was the one moment where I think Jared Leto not only shined as the character, but I think that he had his own agenda. You know, one of my big complaints about the movie is that they just turn Joker and Harley into that couple that are like inseparable and are only thought of as a couple, right? Like whenever you see one of them, you're like, where's the other one? And that's not what the Joker is supposed to be. So here he was his own character, and he wasn't just, you know, a guy who had the hots for Harley Quinn and had to have her back so he could get his hands on her, right? So I loved that. I thought that was so good. Just, and also that he sat on his lap like that, like in a kind of sexual way. I thought it was fantastic. I wish the movie, you know, I guess because it's PG-13, but still, I think they could have pushed the edge of the envelope a little bit more, and scenes like that prove it. All right, so what was the best moment in Suicide Squad? Well, it was my favorite scene, and actually, I feel the only true scene in the movie, and that it had humor, tension, and an arc. You know, that it actually, you know, went somewhere, right? And that was Deadshot's audition. I thought that was so fantastic. I thought everyone in the scene did a good job, from Ike Barinholtz to Will Smith to Joel Kinnaman to Viola Davis. I thought that I liked the different moments of like the different realizations and the beats. You know, it actually had beats, which for this movie is like the only scene that did it. So it had beats, and it also had reveals about the characters. You could see, you know, the dynamics forming for the group. That was really cool. It was one of the best uses of the soundtrack. I was like, Kanye fits here. And it just made Will Smith's Deadshot look really cool. It was the one point in the movie where it lived and breathed and was authentic and organic. And I wish that the whole film was more in the line of that scene. I just really liked it. Everything came together, and that was my favorite moment in the movie. A lot of good jokes. I don't want to give too much away in case you haven't yet seen the film. We'll save that for the spoiler review. But anyway, those are my 5 top moments in Suicide Squad. I'm very curious to hear yours. Be sure to share them down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some more Suicide Squad coverage right now.